Alright, so since most, some of you ASVAB waivers want to ask about my discharge, take notes. Alright, so, went to boot camp September 22nd, 2014. Golf company, platoon 2150. Alright, senior drill instructor was, at the time, Sergeant D, and then I had four following, CD, Ariano, Triplet, and Tolliver. So, after boot camp, went to MCT, had some mental problems, right? didn't speak of it because, you know, I was like, you know, whatever, I'm a Marine, I can do whatever fucking problems are in front of me. went to my first schooling, wasn't too bad. I just missed home a lot because, you know, whatever. There's underlying reasons to that. Longest I had been away from home was like 5 days before boot camp. But, oh well. Things kind of went south when I got to my second schooling. I started having bad thoughts about life. About how nothing in the end is really worth it, if you think about it. At least that's how I sometimes feel about it. Did some things I'm not too proud of. Went to a hospital in San Diego, Balboa. They told me I had depression. They're like, you know, we're gonna get you discharged. Now at the time, I was like, you know, this is great. I'm getting discharged. Amazing. I get to go back home. Well, things aren't always as they seem. I had a lot of people back home saying they missed me, and that kind of added to the, I wanna go home. And I want to get there as soon as possible. And as soon as I got home, they kind of just didn't care for me. Shitty as that is. My first schooling was in Pensacola. My second one was on Camp Pendleton. I feel like there's something I'm missing. Went to boot camp September, stated before, graduated December 19th? Yeah, 19th. Went home for the holiday block leave. Went to MCT like January 8th or some shit, 4th. Till February like 14th. Had my birthday in the field when we were, no. Not in the field, but during the BSRE, that was pretty cool. It wasn't. I learned how to clear rooms on my birthday, so that's something I won't forget, I guess. I should probably not have this planned because, you know, copyright. But the reason I chose Amity Affliction and the background is because, you know, they kind of helped me through some shit. A lot of shit, actually. When I couldn't really talk to anybody. I didn't get this guy till my dad discharged. He's pretty cool. His name's Jericho. Where you going, dude? Apparently he doesn't want to be in the YouTube video. what a dick. Hang on. Alright, he's gonna be in it no matter what. MCT graduated mid-February, got to Pensacola like the morning after we graduated. It was an overnight flight and it sucked. The barracks in Pensacola were nice. I spent month and a half on barrack support, which kind of sucked because all you do is clean day in and day out and up until the weekend. But it's a lot more simple than what I do now. Didn't really know anything about electricity, and I chose aviation electronics for an MOS. That was an adventure. Graduated that schooling. There was a split during my second part of the schooling in Pensacola where you could choose what your MOS was going to be. And I chose eye level. Intermediate level, which is like troubleshooting the components, at least what our schooling was. Made it seem like, anyway. Which was on Camp Pendleton. And I was like, you know, closer to home, this will be better. My face is looking a little chubby. Anyway, had some mental problems during the transition between Pensacola and Camp Pendleton. Just to give you some insight, the barracks should have been condemned that we were living in. There was no form of heating or cooling in the rooms. So that's cool. We were kind of just in the back, behind the airfield, if anybody knows where that is. Like if you're down at the airfield and you take a right at the McDonald's and you follow that road up, you'll go past the schoolhouse. I don't know if they still use those barracks, but they might. Discharge process took about 5 months. I was in Pensacola for 5 months. I was on Camp Pendleton for 5 months, and then 3+ months. So I was in for a year and a month. Year, a month, and 20-something days. Not long enough. I wish I didn't say anything when I was getting discharged, but there were some dark times. I had a friend back home actually hang himself September 1st, 2015, and that kind of sucked. Kind of like, you know, he did it, why can't I? And three days ago now, somebody I used to listen to music as kind of like a therapy for all my, like, you know, being down and, you know, wanting to end it all. I listened to Linkin Park, as edgy as it sounds, and with the recent tragedy happening, it's like kind of going back to that mentality of, you know, if he can do it, why can't I? I mean, he had so much more than I did do. Yeah. It sucks. Getting discharged early. People think about it and they're like, oh, I want to get out as soon as possible. Well, no, you don't. It kind of fucked my life up. I had a plan throughout high school and the first part of my military career. I was like, you know, I'm going to make this a career. I'm going to be like top NCO, senior NCO, whatever. But that didn't work. I was originally going to do this video as like a slam to all those people who are like, dude, you weren't really in, blah, blah, blah. But suicide fucking sucks. I mainly put all my tattoos on this arm because it's kind of like a mitigation towards a certain way that I was thinking about doing it. So it's like, I don't want to mess up the artwork. But I guess that's my story.